The release of two American hostages by Hamas has ignited hope among the families of other captives being held hostage in Gaza. 2 weeks on since the Israel-Hamas war started, hostages' crises continue to grip the war-struck Israel.
Yesterday we saw that two mother and daughter get out from Gaza. The Hamas released them out. From the one hand, it's giving me a hope that my son Omer will be out as soon as possible.
Several countries have come forward to negotiate for hostages with Hamas. Turkey and Egypt both have traditionally played the role of mediator, but this time Qatar has emerged as a significant player. Qatari Foreign Ministry spokesman has now said that hostages could be released very soon. It is continuously engaging with both Israel and Hamas for the release of all civilians. Doha also played a key role in the release of two American hostages on Friday. Judith Tyranan and her daughter, Natalie Shoshana Ranan, are the first hostages to be released.
I feel wonderful. Tonight I'm going to sleep good. I haven't slept good for the last 2 weeks. I spoke with my daughter. She looks good. She feels good. So life is good. She will be 18 next week, so it's the best present. She sounds very, very good, very happy, and she looks good. Just have hope and pray to God. Kiss her and hug her.
The brutal Hamas attack still remains imprinted on the minds of many Israeli survivors. It was on the 7th of October that Hamas took over 200 hostages to Gaza. Some people were abducted from their homes, while some from the Supernova Music Festival. This included Israelis and foreign nationals from countries like the United States, UK, Germany, Nepal, and Thailand, among others. Israel vowed to wipe off Hamas militants after one of the deadliest attacks on its soil in 75 years of its history. It has been ramping its military presence along the Gaza border ahead of an expected ground offensive. But countries whose hostages are still with Hamas have been urging Israel to delay the ground offensive.